outside, ran my KX the other day. Took it down the road, got to the stop sign at the end of my road, and it died on me. My brother came over about 30 minutes before that, got it out. He was gonna ride it down the road. Started it up for his kick, let it warm up. While he was trying to start the other bike for his friend to ride, that one warmed up, got to where you turned it off choke, and as soon as it was about to turn off choke, it died. And it wouldn't start back up. Tried to roll start it, push start it, tried to kick it a million times, wouldn't start back up. So we figured it was just flooded, took it in. I ended up cleaning the spark plug off, it had little droplets of oil on it, and I got the fire back up, and that's when I took it up the road. And it died on me again. Well, I got it to quit putting oil on the spark plug, but now it just don't want to fire for some reason. So, I don't know if it's got a bent valve, it's got all kinds of compression. I don't see it having a bent valve, but who knows. I might need to check up on the valve clearance, make sure I'm getting them right.
Alright guys, here in a little bit I'm going to tear down the CT70 and get it painted. I got a new wiring harness and all the lights and all that, you know, need to be wired up on it. But before I do that, I need to clean up my garage a little bit. I've got parts laying everywhere. And one of the things I need to do is shim the valves up on these. I had an intake valve, or one of them. I'm pretty sure it was an intake valve. It kind of, I guess it bent on me, I don't know. I took it out. I didn't really see a bend in it, but it wasn't sealing. So I went ahead and bought a new one. And I put it in. Now, as it sits right now, it'll start, but it won't stay running. It'll just fire up real quick and then shut completely back down. So, the only thing I know of is the intake valves need to be adjusted just a little bit. So, that's what we're going to go try and do. I'm going to shim them up to get a little tighter. Hopefully that does the trick. So, let's get to it. Turn this off while I look for my tools and then I'll do it back up. Or actually,
I'm gonna go ahead and remove the head off this. You all probably don't want to see all this crap anyway. And then whenever I go to shim it up, I'll get it out and record it. Alright. They're down here. You see how loose that is? I should be able to put this in there that easy.
So we're just gonna take these out. And then I got some over here, and hopefully we'll find a shim that's a little bit bigger. Alright, this is my right one, and that's my left one. I just went ahead and took them both out. Now, let's see what we got here.
So there you go. That one measures at 2.85 millimeters.
So I'm going to open this up, and we're going to go...
measures
290, like it says. 2.90 millimeters. So. I'm gonna go over here and set this one in. Alright, this one's a 2.90. Check it like we did the other one. 2.92, so a little bit bigger. So we'll go to a 2.95. Measures out to 2.96 here. Alright. Go set this one in, and then we'll set the buckets in, and then we'll check it. So this one fits into there, and it grabs it, and then this one feels pretty good.
He grabs it, not as high as the other one, but he grabs it enough. So I think we're good here. I'm gonna go ahead and put the top back on it, and then we'll get this all zipped back together, and we'll see if we can start it up.
1, 2, 3. Oh! Let's see if this thing will start. Today, Junior!
One eternity later.
Yeah, I got my mount made right here. I just welded a piece of 1/8 inch flat steel right here and onto a pipe that I cut. Might be in your way for a little bit, but
thank you.
I gotta spend the rest of the day watching stupid, rather watch paint dry. Nice.
Hit a like button or the subscribe button. If you click on the link right here, it'll take you to our last video. See you guys. Peace out. Take care.